Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. You're watching Zulfo. Good morning everyone, and in this video we are going to study the continued part of the chapter that is human reproduction. So in this video we are going to discuss about the topic of gametogenesis. We already know that what is gametogenesis. Well, genesis is a formation, gametes is a male gametes, whether it is sperm or ovum. So today we are going to study the formation of the gametes, how the gametes gets formed. So in that, we are going to study about the spermatogenesis, in the sense, the formation of sperms. In today's video, we are going to study the how the formation of sperms occurs. So let's move on. We all know that these spermatogonia are the main germ cells which are present in the seminiferous tubules, which are attached to the wall of the seminiferous tubule. So spermatogonia, it is a germ cell, isn't it? So when it gives or when it transfers into the male gamete, that is sperms, this is called as the gametogenesis. Soon after this spermatogonia, which is present or which is a germ cell which is present in the or to attach to the wall of the seminiferous tubule, this undergo mitotic division and forms so many primary spermatocytes. What happens? This spermatogonia undergoes, see, this is a spermatogonia which is diploid in nature. This undergoes mitotic division and forms many cells. Those are called as the primary spermatocytes. These are the diploid primary spermatocytes. Soon after the formation of these primary spermatocytes, these primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division. What these do? These primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division and forms two haploid cells. They are called as the secondary spermatocytes. So this spermatogonia produces the this spermatogonia produces the first spermatocytes by undergoing mitotic division, and this first or the primary spermatocytes by undergoing first meiotic division produces secondary spermatocytes. So these two are the secondary spermatocytes, where these are haploid in nature. Soon after these, secondary spermatocytes undergoes second meiotic division. What happens? These secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division and forms the spermatids. These are the spermatids. So after that, these spermatids transfers into the sperms. So these spermatids transfers into the sperms. This process is called as the spermiogenesis. So this is how the spermatogenesis occurs. So spermatogonia undergoes mitotic division and produces primary spermatocytes. These primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division to form secondary spermatocytes. Same, the secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division and forms spermatids. These spermatids transfers into sperms. This process is called as the spermiogenesis. We come to spermiation. Spermiation is nothing but when the sperms gets released from the seminiferous tubules. That is called as the spermiation. So in order to occur this all the process, there will be some hormones which will be acting on the spermatogenesis. In that, this is gametophage. Okay, these releases two hormones. They are called as the FSH and LH, where FSH acts on the secretory cells, which secrete some factors. Excuse me. These FSH cells acts on the secretory cells, which terminates the some other factors to help in the process of spermatogenesis. We're coming to LH, that is the luteinizing hormone, which acts on the Leydig cells, so which helps in the secretion of the androgens. Those androgen hormone helps in the process of spermiogenesis. This is how the spermatogenesis occurs. And let's move on to the structure of the sperm. So these are the sperms. So let's check the structure of the sperm. This sperm Telescope is a microscopic structure. We cannot see it through our naked eyes. So this worm has three parts mainly: head, middle piece, and tail, and even neck. So this worm is whole body is covered by a membrane called plasma membrane. Soon after that, there is a structure which is elongated on the head that is called as the acrosome. In this acrosome, there are many digestive enzymes present which help in dissolving the membrane of the egg cell so that it helps in the fertilization process. Soon after that, the nucleus, which are haploid in nature, they will be containing the chromosomal material. And this is the neck part. Coming to middle part, that is middle piece, where it consists of numerous mitochondria. These mitochondria helps in the movement or motility of the tail. And coming to tail, which helps in the motility. This is the brief structure of the sperm. Please do remember the structure of the sperm, as it is very important as considered by your exam purposes.